Now things are getting interesting. With all the rumors about DJI's soon to be released new HoverAir is stepping up with two new selfie drones, sparking some much needed competition in the drone market. Hey everyone, welcome back to our drone channel. Let's dive right now into what's happening. DJI has just officially confirmed the Neo for the 5th of September, so the release of the new DJI Neo is just around the corner. Perfect timing, or maybe not so coincidentally, HoverAir is teasing an upgrade to their popular X1 selfie drone, and we're not talking about leaks here, but official announcements on their website and on platform Indiegogo. They are teasing not one, but two new models, the X1 Pro and the so-called X1 Pro Max. Both are set to offer significant video resolution upgrades compared to the original X1, which came out just about a year ago. The original X1 quickly carved out a niche as a compact mini drone in the Z0 class, weighing well under 250 grams. It was an easy pick for quick selfie shots, though its resolution was capped at 2.7K and flight time rarely exceeded 15 minutes. But thanks to its small size, it fits right in your pocket. You know how tiny this thing is because I featured and tested it plenty of my videos. I really love this drone. It's just so incredibly simple to use. By the way, I just wrecked mine in the Atlantic Ocean, but that's a story for another time. Anyway, back to the point. The new X1 Pro will now record videos in 4K at up to 60 frames per second, and it can even hit 120 frames per second in full HD mode. It's got a 1/2 inch CMOS sensor and a 70 millimeter equivalent lens with tracking speed up to 42 kilometers per hour and a max speed of 60 kilometers per hour. Hard to believe, right? For those of you who need even higher resolution for your epic shots, the Pro Max model will support 8K video at 30 frames per second. Guys, the world's first 8K at 30 frames per second flying action cam. It'll also do 4K at 120 frames per second, so going head to head with DJI Mini 4 Pro. Plus, it'll offer a 4K HDR mode at up to 60 frames per second in 10-bit HLG. So capturing your best and stunning moves in slow motion has never been that easy. Naturally, the sensor is larger, clocking in at 1.3 inches, and the lens is slightly wider at 60 millimeters. How do I know all of this? It's so easy because it's all on HoverAir's website. You can find the link in the video description below. And while we are at it, if you like this channel, hit the like button and subscribe because it's free and quite easy. Well, back to the topic. There are more new features worth mentioning. Both models are now suitable for use over water, snow, and cliffs. But I've got to say, I've used the current model a lot and I haven't had any issues flying over water, snow, or even cliffs. If my HoverAir X1 got water damage, it's definitely not the drone's fault. Well, of course, both new models keep their cool, compact and foldable design, so they still fit right in your pocket and you don't need any flight experience because these drones operate completely automatically. Their tracking modes are still super simple, letting the drone take off, fly and land all by themselves. We also know the prices yet since the manufacturer has released that info on Indiegogo. Sure, we already expected them to be slightly more expensive in a range of around 30 to 40%, and it will be between $550 and $1,500, depending on the drone and the bundle you choose. or just take advantage of the fact that the models and bundles are currently available on the platform Indiegogo. You can snag one for as low as $429. What we also can see from the teasers, images and videos is that there will be accessories. There's seriously a ton of stuff available. ND filters for motion blur, carry bags, a power case, thermal batteries that are supposed to work in temps as low as minus 20 degrees, and a beacon. The drone supposedly used the beacon when it's too far away for regular tracking. Plus, we've got joysticks for manual control and, of course, the familiar charging hub. And that's something that wasn't available for the original HoverAir X1. The next few weeks are going to be really, really exciting. According to DJI's leaked ads, the Neo will be similar in the size to the HoverAir X1 Pro, though a bit smaller at 157x130x49mm compared to the HoverAir 173x149x39mm. But let's not forget, the HoverAir drones are foldable, making them even more compact when you're on the go. That's exactly what the HoverAir drones are designed for. They take up hardly any space in your pocket and are ready to go in no time. It also looks like the DJI Neo will be usable with a controller and goggles, offering full manual mode. Well, I wouldn't have expected something else. However, plenty of figures, facts and pictures have been released until today. But the big question is whether it will also have a fully automatic mode where you just pull the drone out of your pocket, select the mode and hit the start button. Overall, DJI will likely have the edge when it comes to manual flights, that's clear. Rumor has it the Neo can fly up to 10 kilometers, but honestly, I think that's a bit much and not really practical. When it comes to resolution though, the Neo lags behind the X1 Pro Max with 4K at 30 frames per second or HD at up to 60 frames per second. The Neo will have a half inch sensor and 40 millimeters equivalent lens. However, sounds pretty awesome to me, and I'm super, super excited to fly this little beast. At only 135 grams and that size, gap flights should be a breeze. We'll see how wind resistant either the DJI and the HoverAir drones will be. Like I mentioned earlier, the Neo has just been announced for September the 5th. While we'll have to wait until at least early October for the X1 Pro and X1 Pro Max, according to the manufacturer's information. This is going to be an insanely exciting comparison between these two drones. This is pretty much a first in the scene since DJI has always been the top dog. Now we're seeing two companies going head to head with their products. Oh, and did you know, both DJI and HoverAir claim that their drones can be controlled by voice commands. So it looks like the Neo might have some level of flight autonomy built in. If done right, a voice command feature could definitely save time when starting and managing flights. Pretty interesting stuff. So guys, what do you think? Are you as pumped as I am? It's going to be an exciting few weeks ahead. And as we all know, competition makes the market better. What are your thoughts of these drones? Are you planning to get one, or maybe even both or all three? Let me know in the comments, and I'm looking forward to a lively discussion. If you like the channel, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe. We'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye bye.